स्पीक अप फॉर SSC रेलवेज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 इज फ्रॉम सिविल सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन कंडक्टेड बाई UPSC. द सब्जेक्ट इज जनरल साइंस एंड द सॉल्यूशन इज एट लास्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो. The article I'm using for my reference belongs to the Deccan Herald and is dated back to 2017. The article is on the title, The Pros and Cons of Mitochondrial Transfer Technique. The link of the article will be there in the descriptions below for further readings. April of 6th, 2016, a new chapter was opened in reproductive biology to help women carrying certain type of genetically mutations to have a healthy baby. So a Jordanian couple who had been trying to start a family for nearly 20 years was able to give birth to a baby boy using DNA of three individuals. So this was the backdrop of the new chapter. So actually the mother carried the genes for Leigh syndrome, which was a fatal disorder which affected the developing nervous system, and this disorder caused the death of their first two children. So using the technique called mitochondrial replacement therapy, a fine birth was achieved of the new baby. So this technique, this therapy is based on the concept of mitochondrial DNA. So let's understand what is mitochondrial DNA. So DNA is stored in the nucleus of a cell. We all know that. There's nothing new. But there's something special about the mitochondria. The mitochondria, which provides the energy, also contains DNA, their own DNA, which is known as the mitochondrial DNA or the mDNA. So we have already learned that we all inherit one set of chromosomes from both our parents, but this condition is not the same with mDNA. The mDNA is always inherited from the mother, from the female parent. So if the mitochondrial DNA undergoes mutations, and if this is present in the mother, then all her offsprings will inherit them. The mitochondrial diseases becomes apparent once the number of defective mitochondria in the organ or in any organ reaches a certain level. Therefore, mothers with few defective mitochondria may not show any symptom. So this was the case with our Jordanian couple. The mother was free of symptoms because she had few defective mitochondria, but she still carried the mutations and that caused the Leigh syndrome. There are two techniques of mitochondrial replacement. One is the maternal spindle transfer and second is the pronucleus. So the pronucleus transfer technique is what the question is all about. Pronucleus is an embryo which is an hour or couple of hours old. First, both the egg cells, the egg cell from the intended mother and the egg cell from the donor female, is made to fertilize with the father's sperm. So after fertilizations, pronucleus is developed in both the egg cells of the intended mother and the female donor, and then the transfer of this pronucleus from the intended mother is done the female donor's pronucleus. That is, there's a replacement of the female donor's pronucleus with the intended mother's pronucleus, and then the embryo is made to develop in the laboratory. Therefore, it involves three parents, one father, two female, and one female with the defected mitochondria. But this technique also involves some skeptics from experts. The skeptics are such as emboldening of methods to create designer babies, the compatibility issue between mother's nuclear genes and donor's mitochondrial genes. Also, a large number of eggs have to be harvested from both the mother and the donor to be able to select our embryo for implantations. So this entails risk for the woman. The extras embryos have to be discarded, which itself is an ethical issues. So due to multiple implantations, we have multiple embryos, and leaving one, all other embryos are discarded. And there also an angle of psychological concerns, such as the identity of the person born through this procedure. So this was all about pronuclear transfer method. Thank you.
This video will be always here. Come back to watch.